Assalamu alaikum friends. Welcome to this MATLAB Simulink tutorial. Today I am going to teach you the remaining steps of the topic on how to apply radial basis function neural network with wavelet transform for power system fault identification and classification. In the first part of this video, we already discussed and successfully obtained the input and output training and testing data. Now let's discuss how to train the radial basis function neural network based upon this input and output training data. Let me first load the input and output training data into workspace. For this purpose, bring the input and output training data if you have saved in any folder as shown here. You can see this input data is saved here. Double click on it. It will be available in workspace folder. Similarly, repeat the procedure to bring the output training data as well as testing data. For the training of radial basis function neural network, a very simple program is used as shown here. For your convenience, I will share the link of this MATLAB program in the description section of this video. You may download it from there. It may be noted that this program remains same for all types of power system. Therefore, you can apply this program to any power system of any size. Let's briefly discuss this training program. The first two lines represents the input and output data by name I and T, where I represents the input data and T represents the target data or output data. The third line represents the error goal, which is set to 0. Fourth line represents the speed constant, which is set to 1 by default. Keep this value as it is. The last line is the initialization of radial basis function neural network and its training based upon input, output, error goal, and speed constant values. Let's start its training by clicking on this play button. You can see radial basis function neural network is very fast and has completed its training within short period of time. With 100 neurons, it has provided highest successful training with error equal to 1.97471 raised to power minus 31, which is equal to 0. It means RBFNN training is successful. Now come to workspace section. You can see net block is available here. This is the trained radial basis function neural network. You have to save this file with any name and in any folder of your choice so that it may be used again for testing. After the successful training of RBFNN, let's discuss how to test the performance and accuracy of radial basis function neural network for all 30 cases. For the testing of radial basis function neural network, a very simple program is used as shown here. For your convenience, I will share the link of this MATLAB program in the description section of this video. You may download it from there. It may be noted that this program remains same for all types of power system. Therefore, you can apply this program to any power system of any size. Let's briefly discuss this testing program. The first line represents the input testing data of 30 cases by name P. The second line is used to simulate the trained radial basis function neural network to test its performance for these 30 cases. Here, Y represents the output of the RBFNN. Net represents the trained radial basis function neural network. And P represents the input testing data of 30 cases. The last line is used to obtain the results in column format. It is not compulsory. You may keep this as it is or remove it if you want. Let's start its testing by clicking on this play button. You can see Radial Basis Function Neural Network has provided the output of all these 30 cases as shown here. Let's compare the output of the radial basis function neural network with the actual output of all these 30 cases. You can see Radial Basis Function Neural Network has successfully and accurately detected the output of all the 30 cases. This shows that it has accuracy of 100%. Friends, in your case, it may give exactly same results or little bit different results depending upon the processor and MATLAB version. In fact, every time you test the neural network, it may give little bit different results due to random initialization of variables chosen by computer and MATLAB itself. Therefore, you may get 100% accuracy or little bit lower. However, it makes no difference. Friends, I want to highlight here that at first I tried to train and test this power system fault identification and classification using simple artificial neural network. However, after more than 1 month of efforts, I couldn't succeed to obtain the reasonable accuracy. Therefore, I changed the type of artificial neural network for better accuracy. After several attempts of trying for different types of ANN, I found Radial Basis Function Neural Network suitable for this model. Therefore, I want to highlight that if you are going to change the power system model such as IEEE 9 bus system or IEEE 14 bus system or any other power system, then you may get different results such as maybe a little bit lesser accuracy or even low accuracy. However, if your accuracy is above 90%, then it is acceptable. Therefore, try to obtain the accuracy up to this range by using this radial basis function neural network or any other type of artificial neural network. Friends, by repeating the same procedure on any power system, you may complete your bachelor degree FYP, master degree research, or one of the PhD research objectives. For your convenience, I have uploaded the PDF Training and Testing MATLAB Programs of RBFNN in the form of link in the description section of this video. You may download it from there. That's all for today's tutorial. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel and share this with all your friends so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.